Hello, this is Alexander Weimann, music director of the Seattle Baroque Orchestra. I'm talking from my home to yours, and while I wish I could be performing for you, today will have to do with you listening to me talking about music instead of making music. We are confined to our homes, and for most of us, this is a first experience in life, and it's not in history. If we think back all those centuries, then especially the field of music that we do, Baroque and pre-Baroque music, was hit by a horrible pandemic worldwide, the Black Plague. And I recently read that even though the biological reason for that infectious disease was found centuries later, by the same measures as we have to endure now, which is isolation, quarantine, social distancing, lockdown, essentially, they managed to master and control that disease even before knowing how to actually cure it. A very interesting example. And the plague, as you may know, played a big role in Europe until the 16 and even in Spain until the 1700s. In the 1600s, a lot of the music shows so much hope and positive outlook despite the valley of tears the composers had to go through. And it's around that time that a term became important that I think is useful also for our times. It's called melancholy. Many of us feel down right now, and in the early 1600s, that general feeling of melancholy was a subject of many letters and treatises, and one of the most extended is by an Oxford scholar by the name of Robert Burton. It's called The Anatomy of Melancholy. And he describes very beautifully how dance and music is actually a treatment for those mental disorders. I'll quote one sentence for you. "But to leave all declamatory speeches in praise of divine music, I will confine myself to my proper subject. Besides that excellent power it hath to expel many other diseases, it is a sovereign remedy against despair and melancholy, and will drive away the devil himself." I will leave you with that little historic excursion, perhaps as a source of consolation. Music in the darkest times is, I think, the best comfort we have, the most humane, the most profoundly human expression. And we are always relying and most grateful for your support. But especially in these times, feeling and knowing about your support is priceless to us. So thank you, and looking much forward to seeing you soon again.